In early October, I got to check out a bunch of films at the Nightstream Film Festival, and one of them is finally coming to video on demand. It's called Black Bear, and it stars Aubrey Plaza and Christopher Abbott. Should it be on your list to watch this weekend? A filmmaker at a creative impasse seeks solace from her past at a mountain retreat. There she finds the woods summon her inner demons in intense and surprising ways. Aubrey Plaza is Allison, and she is our creative filmmaker who goes on the retreat. Almost from the very get-go in this film, there is this odd sense of discomfort. Is it awkwardness? Is it dread? I mean, is something bad about to happen? Or is it just the strained conversations that we're experiencing? Plaza is quiet and mysterious. She's really just private. And she sits in like this trance-like state on a dock on the lake and just stares. And we assume that she's deep in thought, like she's mulling over her next project or her next story. And I love how this staring off into the nothingness really comes into play several times throughout the movie. When Plaza interacts with Christopher Abbott and Sarah Gadon, who are the owners of the retreat, though that entire conversation, all of those interactions are just wrought with tension. I mean, there are relationship issues that are just exacerbated by dialogue. When people talk and when they say certain things, it triggers other people in that conversation and it just spikes them and it makes them react in ways that you can tell that something is not just surface level. I mean, that they are really twinging some nerve that is deep-seated. I like that there are some twists kind of to the story that are executed really well. What these do is they accurately put us into the mind of a creative person, and it can be dark and twisty. The acting by all three is done wonderfully. I mean, they have really good timing and they play off of each other very well and really convincingly. They create this atmosphere that you can feel. I mean, it's weighty, it's daunting, it's palpable. It's just, it's thick with dread, tension, discomfort, just all of those things that you don't want to rush right into. And yet, as we're watching, you can't take your eyes off of. Many stories and films are told in three acts. This one only has two. It could use a third one. I mean, when the film ended, it felt incomplete. Like, the movie ended and I was like, wait, there's more, right? I mean, the story that we do get is enrapturing, but it just feels like there was more that needed to be said, or at least could be said. Saying that though, I'm not sure my brain could handle a third act. The first two are really stressful, especially the second one. The movie is quite dialogue driven too. I mean, the words are like daggers. They're sharp and they're quick. This feels a bit introspective too, kind of like an insider's commentary. We're watching filmmakers comment on the process that they endure and create in their craft. And I think this point might be where the film doesn't totally resonate with everybody. It may just be a little too industry insider, or maybe it's just kind of self-indulgent. I mean, the story is compelling and it is engaging, but it also feels at times like it's not talking to us as a regular audience, that it's talking more towards other actors or other filmmakers or people inside the industry. But it's also giving us a peek behind the curtain at what goes on, and do we really like that? Do we need to know that? Do we want to know that? Both acts have a tension that will keep you glued, but the second one left me feeling a bit dirty and disgusted. I mean, maybe though that was the point. It certainly caused a reaction in me and made it memorable. Now, I may watch this one once more, but I don't think I'm going to revisit it after that. But Plaza, Abbott, and Gadon, they kill it in their performances. I mean, they do such an amazing job feeding off of each other and creating this narrative that at the exact same time I want to watch and I can't look at because I'm so uncomfortable. I'm so just squirming in my seat at some of the dialogue and some of the situations that are happening. And yet, it's a train wreck too. The movie's not a train wreck. It's just that I'm like, sucked in and can't pull myself away, even though parts of my brain are going, stop, look away, close your eyes. You don't need to see, no, this is just, it's not making you better. And to top it off, the story is pretty unique. I mean, this isn't something that I wholeheartedly loved, but it was interesting to watch and it was engaging in a weird way. I wish though, just when it had ended, it didn't feel like it just ended. I wish that there would have been more of a feeling of resolution or completeness to it rather than, hey, we're done, cut. There is sex, nudity, a bunch of profanity, and not really any violence. I give Black Bear 3.5 out of 5 couches. Are you a fan of Aubrey Plaza? Do you have a favorite performance of hers? If so, let me know what it is in the comments below. If you enjoyed this review, please give it a like. Also, don't forget to share and subscribe. I'm Chris. This is Movies and Munchies. Thanks for catching with me.